Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Pro Cycling Manager 2015, where we're playing the Pro Cyclist mode, and we are currently winning the green jersey in Tour de France, which is a genuine surprise and a pleasant surprise. Although I have worked really hard for it, I've probably worked harder than anyone in the competition, considering the way I'm currently gaining my points. That came out weird. Anyways, let's have some soda because that makes me burp and that makes for good content, right? Right, so hilly stage. Uphill on the start. Not that long, not that steep, but steep enough. So if I can just get to. If I survive this climb, I should be able to get this one in if I make it to the breakaway, of course. And I'm not kind of assuming I'm gonna do that. Man, Tlansky has had some tough couple of days. He's 17th. And I'm still generally surprised because Lara is the best average rider in the team.
Welcome back. The final four-day battle for the yellow jersey begins here on stage 17. Today we have a 161-kilometer stage from Digne-les-Bains to the Pralou ski resort. There are four cols on the way, plus a climb to the finish, but none will strike fear into the heart. However, there's still plenty of climbing to be done. The road up to the Col d'Alos from Thorame-Haute is 33 kilometers long, and the final kilometers average out at 7%. Then there's a 16-kilometer descent towards Uvernay-Four for the final ascension to Pralou. It's a 6.2-kilometer climb to the finish on a slope of 6.5%. All in all, a gentle first test in the mountains, which none of the favourites will want to fail.
Right, so we got the intro to the stage by the in-game commentator, which is good. And I'm completely scared. That happens, it's not a big deal. The only way I'll have a chance of actually doing something with that is if the... Peloton doesn't reel us in, which I probably will at some point. So I dropped intentionally because I didn't have to spend the energy following the attacks in the mountains. I honestly feel like I should be able to get back for the sprint.
A fall has just happened in the peloton. Several riders are on the ground.
Well, I did that. Just came up. They is better let that guy go, which is good for me. I managed to keep up. Ready for the sprint. Just to make sure I actually get it. I got it good. That puts me almost 50 points ahead of Crystal. Provisionally. Yeah, this is not coming for me. Two strong climbers in the breakaway. That's okay. I can just take it easy myself. Shouldn't take it too easy though. I would want to try to keep the peloton behind me instead. In front of me. Imagine if I got in front of the peloton. That would be a lot more points. And that might just happen today. no guarantee that it'll happen, but it's a possibility. If I work for it, I might just have a different one. Alright, so I'm losing time to whoever that is probably...
A courageous rider is looking to break away!
Monoma, the yellow jersey. And of course I get dropped, that's no big deal. I'm head of the youth competition, or youth jersey guy, but I'm all pretty much an hour behind, so it's not a big deal. There's Kletkovsky. There's the... My team's mates, I think, at the minute. I didn't get any green jersey points, but... And Bongiorno won again. That's his first stage. Great race for Katusha. It's been a great stage for me as well. Was not strong enough in the upper to... get much out of the stage after the sprint, but that was as expected, to be honest.
And here are the race highlights that we've selected for you.
Yeah, I figured. What is the chess Czech champion? Or Slovak champion? Not Czech. Slovak champion, I think. No, he's Italian. Yeah, I lost a lot of time compared to the right-weighted guys, but then again, I took it a lot easier than them. So that's good. Yeah, I don't think I'll get much here, but I'm going to try to get... I'm going to try to attack after the second category, I think. And take it from there. I guess this starts right at the second category here, and that is a bit too much for me. I have a decent lead in the points competition, but it's not big enough for me to feel safe. But if Christoph gets any points there, I'll actually be quite surprised. Because this looks like one hell of a stage. And Andrew Talensky is a part of the outsiders for the stage together with Froome, and I didn't catch the last name, but Talensky is not going to do well.
Hello and welcome back. Stage 18 and day 2 in the Alps. It starts with a 6.5 km climb out of Gap towards the Col Bayard, and ends 185 kilometers later with a gentle finish in Saint-Jean-de-Maurienne. In between lie the 1,368 meters of the Col de la Motte, the altogether more daunting 1,924 meters of the Col de Glandon, as well as the Lacet de Montvernier, which make their first appearance in the Tour de France. The latter is a narrow and winding 3.4 kilometer climb at over 8%. Lying only 10 kilometers from the finish. The race favorites will therefore have to make sure that they're well placed before reaching Pont-à-Mafré. 30 seconds are easily lost, and the Tour has been won on less than that.
Right, so as you can see, I obviously changed my mind when I saw that it didn't start in uphill. It had a couple seconds in the start, which was flat, and I used that to my advantage. Didn't keep up with these guys, but I say acceptable anyways because I caught them in the landslide, I mean in the down descent. Which is some reference, the last one caught. not to suggest looking in that view. Anyways, do as I do best, attack, get a few mountain points and a lot of sprint points. France crew in Norway, not this to France. If this was real life, two Norwegians compete with New Jersey. I would have been all over that ship. To that, it's very likely to ever happen. The two Norwegians competing with New Jersey. This year's Tour de France, we didn't even have one. That was a new competition. It didn't fly. And Cassara fell. But no important rider, to be honest. Right, so. One guy ahead. Did he attack or? Yeah, he did attack. I guess because I don't do my part. Oh crap, I didn't pay attention.
The list of those left behind goes on rising.
I'm just gonna go back to the back. Excuse me. My teammates with me on this group yesterday. I wonder if I'll be able to keep my 50th place overall, or maybe I'll even climb. Maybe I'll even climb some. I mean, I have the chance on this stage actually to climb some, in theory at least. That fell, not a big deal. But I prefer to take it easy. I've had my finish line. I didn't do it properly, but I had it. Sorry, I wonder if I'll catch him again. I'm going to stop the pace a bit so I can make sure to reach the time limit properly. No one. Lansky got 9th, which is good. Pretty sure I got the best stage, single stage result for my team, but I don't really care. I got 3rd place, got a jersey that stage, lost it the next stage, and then I won it back. I never lost it so far. Now, I didn't get the 20 points I should have gotten, but I still gained. So even though I didn't pay attention, I know it's being stupid. It's all good. And if I'm lucky, Christoph doesn't make time with it. Because Christoph is the only one that can realistically catch me.
But now for the race highlights!
It'll be too far behind for the others, I think. Points. Yeah, I got 11. Well, I could have had 20, but hey. I'm more than 50 points ahead. And I think. Yeah. Charles Jose is the only stage where he should get points. Right. Another stage where I have a shorts race, basically, because of the finish line. Attack in the start, as usual. Try to get the sprint. Hopefully don't die on the way up. Nah, should be far enough on the bottom of that first category and until the end for me to catch any strong climbers. That might have gotten ahead in the climb. But I won't win the stage, that's for sure. There's no way in hell they let me get away. There's no way in hell that I'm strong enough to...
Welcome back to Saint-Jean-de-Maurienne for the start of stage 19, which in part echoes stage 12 of 3 years ago. The peloton will begin their 138-kilometer day in the saddle by riding back up to Montvernier, and will continue climbing for another 10 kilometers to the Col de Chaussée. Then it's down into the valley for a 30-kilometer round trip along the River Arc. Later on, at Saint-Étienne-de-Cuisne, the riders begin a 22.4-kilometer climb to the Col de la Croix de Fer via the Glandon. The slope averages out at 7%, but it harbors sections at 9 and 10. Then they head back to Saint-Jean-de-Maurienne via the Col de Molard for an 18-kilometer climb to the finish in La Toussuire. Then it's off to bed to dream about the Telegraph, Galibier, and Alpe d'Huez.
Wow, I'm just amazed at how hard the peloton is riding at this stage, this early. I saw Talansky attacking in the first climb. That looks startling when it comes to the points. I need to attack downhill, because I want to be ahead of the peloton ideally.
Oh, the list of those left behind goes on rising!
I didn't get much points. Andrew Talansky got it. Interestingly enough, that means I. Now that's 57, slightly harder than I usually do. And try it, if not. Get that race. Because this pace is way too hard for me. It's way, way too hard. Not only on struggle. This is down a little bit. And he's struggling as well. He's struggling more than me. Not that I'm struggling, I'm taking it a little bit, taking it easy, so I'm not really struggling. I wonder if I catch someone who's just overexerting themselves up here. That would be fun. I mean, I am currently 55th, I lost a 50th place, but not a big deal to be honest. Talansky is still in front. Rohendan is in what pulls, as they say in Norway. No wait, that's not in front, that's just ahead of me. I'm together with Sagan and James Thomas. That's what I'm impressive. Thomas is obviously going to ride ahead of me, but that wouldn't be past me.
Thibaut Pinot goes onto the attack.
We're into the downhill section. The riders can take a breather, but they can't let their guard drop. Only 15 kilometers left.
Yes. I don't care if people are dropping me or whatever. Is that downhill again?
There's a mass crash in the pack, but it doesn't look too serious.
Well, last climb, time to increase the pace to make sure I reach the time limit. Other than that, it's just some quick Kotlansky. Finishing ahead of my teammates by Jonas, which is always fun. You can always have fun. I spoke too soon. It passed me again. Damn it. Confound it all. Anywho, I didn't get in a single sprint point this stage. Too hard in the start for me. Now if only... The only way this will be successful for me is if this stuff doesn't make the time.
Now for the race highlights!
Some didn't, I noticed. But yeah. Right, so I finished 73rd. And... There's a lot of people that didn't make the time limit, including Cancellara and Tombon. But Taylor Finney did it. Gripple did. Is Gripple even worth? Yeah, it's still worth. Not bad to bring to a grand tour like this. Christoph obviously did. So, yeah. Yeah, 25th, two stages in, two short stages actually, but yeah. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, I hope you've enjoyed, and I will see you for the last two stages. Take care, everybody.